So you are, you've been a bit busy man this week.
A busy bitch.
Busy man this, wasn't busy man this year.
A busy bitch. Kind of came out of nowhere, like you've been in fuck all for a year and a half and then
all of a sudden, Jen's hot topic, huh?
Although somebody did say on Twitter, does anybody else lay in the bed at 4 a.m. with her half just reciting Darren Conway and Jen Hatton sketches to each other? I was like, I have made it.
Oh my God, people. Oh, really?
Look at us. It was one girl, but I'm delighted. Like,
yeah, I mean, one's enough. You've touched one person's soul. You've touched enough people, huh? That's how we go forward.
Yeah, I was filming with the lads. I can't wait to see it coming out now.
Who's your fave?
Huh?
Who's your fave?
Who's our Darren and Joe?
Yeah.
I don't have a favourite. They're both my favourite.
Yeah, fucking political.
My favourite is... Little audio trick there.
Oh my God, you're cool.
I did it with my dick. I still don't have that on them two fucking sounds. I don't know how to get them on. I can't download sounds. I don't know how to download them.
Can anyone help us?
Stupid fucking Mac. But that's what I'm like, when would we even use that? And people suggested the Jason Derulo sound, which is fucking genius, but I don't, when would we use it? Never, probably.
No, we'd use it in bits and...
In bits. We'd find...
Drips and drabs.
We'd do it just because we fucking have it.
Yeah, I'd be like, Jason Derulo. So.
Anyway, you're very welcome along to the Unpopular Opinion Podcast. My name is Jen.
I'm Manna McCalla.
And together we are Jen and McCalla. And we do the TUO.
And we do that. We also do 5 extra episodes a month on Patreon.
We surely fucking do.
There's 6 bleeding your eyes, you guys. You can listen to more of us shy talk.
Yeah. The link's in the description of the podcast. So we'll have a little look there and go over. But in this episode, talking about nightmares.
You chose this. Why did you choose this?
I just think it's interesting.
I just like it.
I like it.
Just like being scared.
I think it's kind of more, because it's so different. It's mad how we have all these thoughts when we're asleep.
Yeah.
And although I find it boring when somebody turns around and said, oh, wait, you hear about the dream that I had last night. I'm like,
there's nothing more boring than,
doesn't interest me.
No.
And I say it because I just feel like people need to know when I do have a mad dream. Do you know when it's acceptable? When it's a family member or somebody that you know very intimately. Like if Adam had a dream and I was in it, I'd be interested.
Really?
Do you know?
Here we are about to do a podcast on something that I don't find that interesting. I'm the same. I'm just kind of like, you know, when someone's like, oh, I had a dream. You're like, here we go.
Yeah. You had it on the list though.
I did have it on the list, yeah.
Of topics to talk
about. Because I find them interesting. I think also because the Japanese baby story really scared people.
It did. That was in Italy? Rome.
Roma, yeah. Was that on Main or on Patreon?
That was just on Instagram, wasn't it?
Really?
Yeah.
Okay, so quick little rewind for you guys. I went to Rome with Tom back in 2019 and... I think it was my sleep paralysis demon. I'm not entirely sure. But basically, I woke up in the middle of the night and there was like this Japanese baby, which is, I'll never forget the pose and the smile on his face. It was fucking uber creepy, right beside my bed, like staring at me, like his head in his hands, just staring at me, a creepy little baby smile. And I mean, Tom said I shot up. Like I fucking shot up.
Why wouldn't you shoot up?
Yeah.
That's terrifying.
It was terrifying. So but it was one of those that, and when I told the story before, it was a lot more interesting, a lot more in depth.
But it was fresh in your head, wasn't it?
Fresh in my head, yeah. And everyone was like, that gave me chills. Like the amount of people that wrote to me being like, that creeped me out so much. And I was like, I'll never forget that moment. It's just one of those things, I'll never forget it, ever. I'll never forget the image of that Japanese baby staring at me.
Yeah.
In my bed.
But it's strange as well what people, because like obviously people are scared of different things.
Yeah.
And things that would freak one person out would be like fine for another person. So like I feel like I've had nightmare, and this is probably going to be a memory unlock type of episode, because when I was thinking about this, I was like, there's not nothing that really jumps out, but I do remember having dreams that I felt like I got the ick off the dream, do you
yeah,
know?
And then you wake up and you're like, oh God, bleh. Yeah.
Like, have you ever smelled something in a dream?
Yes.
Weird.
Strange.
Very weird. Like, a smell that wouldn't be in your room, but you smelt it in your dream.
Yeah.
So fucking weird. I remember having a dream that there was, and I think I said this on the podcast before, you know in the Liffey, where there's steps going down into the river?
Yeah.
I was standing on the banks of the river.
Oh God, and that gave me the creeps there. I just got a little shiver.
Did you?
I hate the Liffey.
This isn't even, like, that bad. Mm-hmm. Liffey was at a low level. Right, and at the bottom of the steps on the other side of the Liffey, there was a crab.
It was a trolley.
No, it wasn't a trolley. It was a crab. And he was standing there. And I don't know why this crab, there was something about him.
Yeah, he gave you the ick.
He gave me the ick. Yeah. It was like he was fucking a pervert.
Yeah, you're like, oh, something weird.
A pervert
something
crab.
Sinister about that crab.
And there was a smell in it. And I woke up going, oh God, that just gave me. And every time I see a crab now, I think of that dream. But like, to me, like to somebody else, that'd be like, fine, it's a water creature,
yeah,
near water, you know, it's fine, it makes sense. But to me, I'm like, get away from me, stop trying to hunt me. Like it, I don't know what it was, the atmosphere, it was a culmination of things that just made me feel like this crab was a fucking sexual predator or something.
Was it like a cloudy day?
It was a cloudy day, yeah, cloudy I was day. Rotten. And then another dream, I had a fella, he had like long... You know the... Did you ever see Hocus Pocus?
Yeah. You know, for years now. But yeah.
You know the two lads at the end? They're like the two bullies, the boys. And one of them has long blonde hair.
Yeah.
Kind of looks like your man in John Bon Jovi's video, I Will Always Love You. Oh, the other fella.
Yeah. You were on fire with the descriptions today.
You know what I'm talking about when I say that though. And this fella, he was...
very attractive, by the way.
Yeah, but I got the
ick. Oh, you got the ick.
In me dream. And I can't even remember what was happening. I just remember this vision of the fella, and he was topless, and he was wearing like low-rise jeans, and he was a bit sweaty, and there was a smell. And I was like, get away. No, I couldn't get away fast enough. Like, and I feel like I always get these kind of dreams when I'm sick, because that is one of the things that can trigger a nightmare, is when you have a fever.
Yeah.
Because I was like, why do you only get them summertime? Now, I know some people have actual conditions where they get night terrors and they have insomnia, and it's a, like, a lot of people that have anxiety are more prone to getting triggered into having nightmares and stuff like that. There are actual causes of them, but like it's different from a, like, just say a bad dream, because the actual definition of it, a nightmare is it's also called a bad dream, but it's different. It's an unpleasant dream that can cause a strong emotional response from the mind, typically fear, but also despair, anxiety, and great sadness. However, philosophical nomenclature differentiates between nightmares and bad dreams. Specifically, people remain asleep during bad dreams, whereas nightmares can actually awaken you.
Yeah, see, that's... It's a real weird one, because I always find that if I have a nightmare, it'll be if I woke up at, say, at 6... and I don't need to be up till 8.
Mm.
It's that period that I go back to sleeping. Do you get me? It's not before.
Yes!
It's not the big sleep that I just had.
No.
It's the mini sleep. It's always in that fucking mini sleep.
It's the most vivid type. Yeah. It's because it's REM sleep.
But REM is the deepest form of sleep.
No, REM is... Oh, is it? I thought REM... No. REM isn't... REM is rapid eye movement, obviously. But it's not, because your brain is more active in that. So deep sleep, you tend not to have the... more vivid dreams are the dreams that you can remember. It's the rapid eye movement sleep, so you're not deep enough.
So I'm wrong. So I, because I thought you had to
be in a deep sleep,
be in REM state.
Yeah, REM state. That, but that's not deep sleep.
Oh.
It's actually a hot.
That's before
you're more awake in REM sleep.
Yeah. Oh.
Your brain is more active, and there's I would agree with that. Like, if I wake up, it is that. Mm.
That little period of time.
You could go to sleep for 20 minutes and wake up fucking traumatised from whatever, like, dream you're after having.
Totally traumatised.
Yeah. So what causes nightmares in adults? Nightmares in adults are often spontaneous, but they can also be caused by a variety of factors and underlying disorders. Some people have nightmare after late night snacking.
Yeah, so this was interesting. So there was a tweet going around, and it was an American girl, and she was, like, saying all that she was living in the UK. And she was basically saying like all the things that she's kind of like that were just that just aren't a thing in America or in the UK. And she was like, I find it so funny how anytime I have a bad dream, people are like, did you eat a lot of cheese last night?
Yeah. Do you ever don't eat cheese after 9 o'clock?
Did you eat a lot of cheese? Yeah, you had a bad dream. Cheese. Yeah. What is that?
I don't fucking know. But the whole
why the cheese?
Let me look that up. But for the moment, the late night snacking can increase metabolism and signal the brain to be more active. So that's you're more likely to have REM sleep, and that's your brain is more active during that time. So that's why you end up having nightmares. But a number of medications are also known to contribute to nightmare frequency. Drugs that act on chemicals in the brain, such as antidepressants, narcotics, and they're often associated with nightmares. And non-philosophical medications, non-psychological medications, including some blood pressure medications, can also cause nightmares in adults.
There's nothing worse, by the way. I just like to put that out there. Personally, there's nothing worse than feeling terrorized before you go to sleep. Like, the scariest movie to me, and when you really think about it, is fucking terrifying, is Nightmare on Elm Street. Imagine not being able to sleep.
Oh, God, yeah.
And knowing that if you do, you will get murdered.
Freddy Krueger's there.
And it's all, like, the worst.
Yeah, that would be horrible.
But imagine knowing that. Like, imagine being like, and you know what it's like when you're so tired and all you want to do is sleep.
I'd be like, Edward Cullen, take me.
I totally get this whole insanity. You'd get that whole mental breakdown kind of gig.
Yeah, you'd want to become a vampire so you wouldn't have sleep.
Yeah.
And you could also probably fucking kill Freddy Krueger. Withdrawal from medications and substances including alcohol, tranquilizers may trigger nightmares. If you notice a difference in your nightmare frequency after a change in medication, talk with your doctor. And sleep deprivation can also contribute to adult nightmares because kids have nightmares more so than adults. So it's a higher percentage of like the younger population would have nightmares. So like nightmares in children like between 5 to 12 years old is about 20 to 30%, and for adults it's between 8 and 30. So like you kind of grow out of them, do you know?
Yeah.
So I don't know whether it's their imagination being more active.
I want to go back to this whole bad dream versus nightmare thing.
Mm-hmm.
Because I feel like with a bad dream.
But that's what I'm talking about. It's different for different people because it's different perspectives. Like, to me, the crab was a nightmare.
Yeah.
To you, the crab might be a bad dream.
See, that's what I mean. Because I'm like, there's dreams that I've woken up from, particularly when I'm away. Like in Spain, I just got back from Spain, from Valencia. I had lots of horrible dreams over there.
I always feel like when you're on holidays, or the lead up to a holiday.
Is it like because you're in a weird room?
Yeah.
Different temperatures? I don't know. But More drink. Yeah, could have been the dehydration.
Yeah.
It's quite good with my waters. But anyway.
It's a mirage. You're in a pretty high temperature. Low hydration.
I find like there was a good few things where I woke up and I was like, oh, hated that. But I had like a feeling.
Yeah.
But I wouldn't be like, I had a nightmare. And there's sometimes I'd be like, that was a nightmare. Do you know?
Yeah. Yeah.
You know?
Oh, I know.
So it's like, you know, it's hard to...
I'm going to go ahead and say a nightmare is something that you remember for years.
Yeah, like the crab.
Yeah, the crab, I've never forgotten.
But I don't feel like, see Japanese baby, that was real.
It wasn't a nightmare, it was real life.
I don't know.
It was IRL, in real life.
It was IRL for me. I don't know, it's such a weird one. I'm like, it wasn't really a nightmare because it was a moment.
Yeah.
And I was awake.
Were you awake?
I think so. I don't know. See, this is what I mean.
Yeah.
Sometimes you feel like you're awake. And you know them dreams where you feel like you're awake and you're like, this cannot be happening.
Oh, God.
This cannot be happening. Mm-hmm. They're the worst ones.
Mm-hmm.
Where you're like, this is actually happening in front of me. I can't believe this is my life. And then when you wake up, you almost feel relief and sadness all at the same time.
When it's really vivid, it is kind of... I suppose I have woken up from... Like, nothing that's really stuck with me, but I have, like, dreamt that people have been dead. And then I woke up and I had that moment where I was like, thank fuck, and then you just feel so grateful in the morning and it nearly gives you a new lease of life because it's like, look at how lucky I am, and you know, all that kind of stuff. Them to me would be nightmares. because it's like you wake up fucking panicking and it takes a second to realise your reality again.
But like there was one, and it was a nightmare in particular, where Tom was cheating on me.
Mm.
And I feel like lots of people have had the same kind of nightmare. I couldn't look at him for a good while. No. He was like, you would not look at me for like a good week.
Fuck's sake.
I was very hurt.
Are you?
Very upset. I've dreamed Tom.
I've cheated on Adam in my dreams.
See, I have also cheated too. And I remember being like, oh my God, how the fuck am I going to fix this? You know, and then when you wake up, you're like, relief that I didn't do that.
Thanks be to Jesus.
Oh my God.
I knew I didn't have it in me.
She was like, oh my God, thank God. That was not worth it.
I've had dreams, and do you know in my dream, it's always the worst because it's not just cheating on Adam, it's cheating with my ex on Adam, and it's horrible. And in my dream, I'm like, why?
Did I do this?
Absolutely not into this.
So
totally into me fella that I'm with now. Absolutely not into me ex. So why am I doing this?
Like, why are you playing tricks on me?
Why have I done this?
Yeah.
This has given me major ick. This is fucking disgusting. Why? And then I wake up and I'm like, knew it.
Yeah. knew that was not me.
Knew I would not do that.
Knew I wouldn't do that. No way. Absolutely not.
Oh, it's horrible.
Yeah, but I feel like in my whole thing was, you've ruined it. I was like, I can't believe
what we had.
You've ruined, I can't believe you've ruined it.
Mm-hmm.
I remember just being like, it'll just never, I can't, like, I was so, and in my dream, I was just like, it'll just never be the same.
It went deep, like, yeah.
And then I woke up and I remember being like, oh.
God.
Oh God, that was rough.
Yeah, yeah.
Don't want to feel those feelings again. It's like, how do I feel all of the feelings in the dream?
Yeah.
You know?
But is that's a bad dream though? Not a nightmare? Because I feel like a nightmare is,
they don't always have to be scary. No, that would be my personal nightmare.
That's what I mean. Nightmare. Yeah, you see, it's all about perspective. Like, to me, a nightmare would be like a monster's after you, or you see fucking load of gore.
Yeah.
Like a literal horror film happening in front of your eyes, whereas a bad dream is like when something bad happens. Do you know?
Yeah.
But I think, like, it obviously, that's the differentiation about it. It's like, you wake up in a fucking panic, so whatever that is, whatever you deem to be like panic inducing.
Do you have any from when you were younger that you remember?
I can't remember. And like, I remember one, but it wasn't a nightmare. I just remember it all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It was Boy George. Boy George was in it. I was in this room. I feel like it was a shopping centre somewhere, and I was walking down this hall, and like Boy George was there. You know what? The iconic George, Boy George, like he has his braids.
Yeah.
Or his cornrows, like with this plaits in his hair, and then the top hat.
Yes.
And he's there and he's just kind of swinging, but he looks up and he's no face. That's what it was. And I was just walking past him and he was just looking at me. I remember that from when I was a kid.
Oh God.
Yeah.
Very odd.
Just very scary, like.
Why was he there?
I don't know. Obviously he had seen him on Top of the Pops or something like that. Something when I was a kid.
Something when I was a child.
Yeah.
I had one, and I don't know if it was, so I used to have this childminder, and like,
was it Peg?
It wasn't Peg, no. It was
the one before Peg. Pre-Peg.
And I just never liked her house.
Right.
I never liked the vibe.
Right.
And I remember I was watching this show, and it was like, I wish I could remember. It was something to do with a swamp. It's like a swamp man. It was a cartoon.
Okay.
It had a theme tune, if anybody could remember it.
Oh, I'm kind
of. Are you getting a bit of a black? And it was that kind of, you know that animation? You know that kind of animation? There's like a series nowadays that almost uses that same similar animation. And it's like the bloke is kind of like tall with the muscles and the, like, it's like a Tarzan kind of, but it's not Tarzan. I feel like people listening will understand what I'm trying to say. It's like a Tarzan build, but not Tarzan with like a blonde hair. Swamp thing.
What? Is it Swamp Thing? Yeah, there is a Swamp Thing. It was a 1991 series.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That would have been, was it Swamp Thing? Let me see.
Animated. I don't know. Was it, like, does that ring a bell?
Maybe I'm confused. Yeah. So maybe I'm like mixing. So this is what I mean. Maybe I'm mixing up like that cartoon with a different cartoon. But to me, in my head, when I was five, it was all the same kind of game.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
But I feel like that kind of feeling and that vibe.
Right.
Yeah. Ish. But not quite. It was more human.
More human.
I'm trying to think. Is it like, you know, Flash?
Was it Gigantor?
Show me Gigantor. Maybe it was him.
Gigantor had a shit theme song as well. It used to fucking...
Yeah, you know, that's what I mean. It's like, it gives you the ick.
Yeah.
Oh, I even remember that now. I hated
so
that.
It was so shit. Man, we the fucking team tune at Gigantor. Jesus.
It was definitely a man. Something weird about him walking out of a water with kind of stuff on him.
Okay.
So...
Can't Google that.
If... No. That's fine. No, that's... Absolutely okay. If anybody knows what I'm talking about, could you let me know? Yeah, that I'm not fucking crazy. And but I took that taste, that flavor, mm-hmm. from that whole kind of self,
the gaff. Yeah,
from the gaff and the watching of that stuff in the gaff and the vibes that I got in general from being that young, mm-hmm. and took it like into this dream. But the dream is really weird, and I can't remember if I did this on, because we did a podcast on actual dreams, guys. If you like, a lot of people were writing in with their nightmares, being like, "Find it so interesting." We actually did one on dreams. I think it was last year, maybe.
Yeah, it was a while ago.
Just search our handle and search our. Just put dreams. So basically it was like this. There was green cheese, and it was like, I don't know if it was green because of the whole swamp situation. Anyway, it was green cheese, and everybody eating the green cheese, and they turned into these weird green alien kind of people. And my family had done it, and I was the only person who hadn't eaten the green cheese, and they were like chasing me around. But like, also I like ran out of my house, and I was in this weird like there were spaceships.
Mm-hmm.
It was such a fucking weird nightmare.
Right.
And obviously it stayed with me for a good 25 years. So there you go.
Yeah. It is mad how we remember one from kids.
Yeah.
Like from when we were kids. Yeah.
That and the witches. You know Rodell's witches?
Yeah.
Was that Angelica Houston?
Is that the one with the mice in it?
And they take off their face. That
oh yeah, you said.
Yeah,
you
I said this
that
before.
That's terrifying, yeah.
Terrified me. Terrified me, girls.
All right. So unfortunately, there are steps you can take, and your doctor can take to lessen the frequency of your nightmares and the effect that they're having on your life. First, if your nightmares are the result of a particular medication, you may be able to change your dosage, obviously. For people whose nightmares are caused by conditions such as sleep apnea or restless legs, there's treatments that can be given for that, obviously. This is all just got to do with your doctor. So go to your doctor. I thought they were going to say
Jen's on
like
WebMD.
You could do, yeah, and they're shit. They're absolutely well. I suppose they're really Jen's trying like, to fucking.
If you're feeling any of these things, please go see your doctor.
Go see your doctor. Yeah, and they're obviously trying to advocate for the doctors, aren't they? Fucking. Yeah.
If there's any other kind of things that you are feeling, please go see your doctor too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, a nightmare.
Oh, on Elm Street.
No, it was on the Wikipedia page for nightmares as well. There you go. We put this out to our listeners and we got quite the response.
Yeah, a lot of you have had nightmares. I haven't looked at any because I didn't want to upset myself. Which is very unlike me.
I haven't looked at them either.
No,
you know?
Very unlike me.
I do not.
You know me. I can't wait.
So you're getting these
awaited.
Raw.
So I'm going to give you raw emotions and expressions and, yeah, didn't really want to dive into, like, everybody's collective trauma without Jen.
Yeah.
Wanted Jen here.
A little bit hungover.
Jen to protect me. Yeah. Just a little bit hungover. Cool. So we'll get straight stuck in. What I loved is I put up the box. We have a listener called Luke, and he is, like, quick at it. I put up the story 2 seconds later. It was like nightmares. So
yeah,
go look. Whenever I feel under the weather or a bit sick, I always have a nightmare that I climb on a tree down my granny's road and I fall off it, but I'm falling for ages. I feel like that might be quite common.
I hate those ones.
It's like, it's anxiety, isn't it? That's just, it's like you're suspended in this thing.
So it's different from nightmares, but you know, like you'll have those dream kind of explainers.
Yeah.
And, like, usually when you're falling, you'll never hit the ground in a dream.
Yeah.
But you kind of shake awake, you know, because in your dream you're like, oh, fuck, I'm falling. And then your actual brain is like, when am I going to hit the ground? Yeah. And then you kind of shake yourself awake. But it's all got to do with things being out of control. in your life and you can't control whatever it is. Same with your teeth falling out.
Yeah, that was a big one, wasn't it?
Yeah, your teeth falling out. I actually had it for the first time ever, but it was when I got my braces. Oh. I think I was just thinking about my teeth, and like I just pulled my brace down and a whole lot of my top jaw just came out.
Oh.
It was fucking mad.
Jaw swinging.
First time I'd ever had a dream, but it wasn't like the way people explain it. You know the way that you think people just have their dream and their teeth start going clink, 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 yeah. clink, clink, and yeah. falling out. Like, no, my hole, it was still attached. It was like a denture coming off. That's the way it was in my dream. I had to try and keep pushing it back up. It was wrong.
I've never had a teeth dream.
No, I hadn't up until that point. So in the last year I got it.
Which is a bit strange, do you know? So we have a voice note.
Okay.
From another listener. So I'm going to go right ahead and play it for you guys.
Hello, this is my response for the nightmares episode. So basically ever since I can remember, like, I've had nightmares since I was a teenager. I'm now 27, and they are extremely, extremely vivid, always, every time. And they're so vivid to the point that sometimes when I wake up, I can't tell the difference between real life and the dreams or nightmares themselves. So, like, some aspects, you know, not like the whole thing, but some aspects. So I actually have to ask friends and family if that actually took place, like some details, which is so weird. And they're just like exhausting as well, because your brain is actually...
Part two?
Yeah, so your brain is not actually getting the rest it needs because the nightmares are so vivid. So it's like a vicious cycle. You wake up, like, exhausted. So there's no real escape. But I don't know, I've never actually mentioned it to anyone really before, but yeah, they are very, some of them are really terrifying, actually, the nightmares themselves. So for example, one, like, trigger warning, one was when, like, I was actually getting raped. Like, it's terrifying. I had, like, one of the act of it, and you just can't escape. Like, ones are when you're getting murdered and you can't escape. It's sort of like an outer body experience, honestly, because you feel like you're looking at yourself getting murdered, if you get me.
Oh, jeez.
So weird.
And we've one last voice note.
And you always, you can't see a face in your dreams, apparently, that you've never seen before. So... Well, in my dreams, there's always somebody there that I know. And then, like, after a nightmare, I wake up. Honestly, my whole body is covered in sweat. Like, my whole body is soaking with sweat. So, yeah. Not fun. It's weird when it blends in, like, the reality blends in with the nightmare. It's very strange altogether. But, yeah, that's my experience.
I would fucking hate that. Like, I know, obviously, I've had dreams and nightmares before where I'm like, oh, God, it takes me a minute to come around and be like, oh, that's fine. That wasn't real. That wasn't, you know. Like I said, wouldn't cheat on my fellow with my ex, for example.
Yeah.
Like, kind of knew, like, I would know what the story is. But having to wake up and ask family and friends about certain aspects, that would be fucking terrifying.
But also, it would be so hard to explain.
Yeah. God.
Like, she was saying there that she's never really kind of told people, which it's a personal choice. I would tell. I have a podcast. I don't shut the fuck up. But, like, I would tell.
Yeah.
Everyone. And you guys, probably, if that was kind of the case.
Mm-hmm.
So I'd say that's really hard as well to be like, did that actually happen? And they're like, no. And you're like, okay, so gotta kind of half explain that now.
Yeah.
More questions.
Especially when they're sinister like that, where she's had dreams of being...
I had a dream before about being raped. It was, honestly, not a dream, a nightmare. It was the worst thing.
Jesus.
It was horrific, yeah.
It's bad enough in a dream, I'm not trying to compare them, but it's bad enough when you're like running away from something and you feel like you can't get out of a situation, let alone that.
Yeah, it's like things that stay with you, isn't it? Like,
God,
I just, how could you lead a normal life? And that's what I mean about like Nightmare, not to keep going back to that one, but like like Nightmare on Elm Street, I'm like, that I think would actually be, that would be enough to send me off the fucking script now.
Yeah. Recording nightmares when I was a kid that my ma left me outside the travel agents in the Omni and went on our holidays. 20 odd years later, we still talk about it like it actually happened. I'm traumatised. See, it's just shit like that, that, like...
The Omni.
It sticks. You're so specific.
The fucking Omni.
Cassidy travelling on the Omni. Yeah. Budget travel, whatever it was. The actual Omni. Fuck. Yeah, no, not good. And it's the kids ones that I think, even though they probably weren't that sinister, like Boy George without a face, you know, it still sticks with you.
Boy George.
Because
the crab. Baby, pervert crab. Yeah,
because baby Jen was traumatised by it.
Yeah.
You know?
Ah, the poor thing.
Yeah. I always have wild dreams, and when I was a child, I used to always dream of standing at the end of my bed, watching myself sleeping. But when I would turn and look and see a man standing beside me, also watching me sleeping.
What?
I don't know who it was, and it always freaked me out. Also, not too long ago, I had a dream that our world was all of us living in a box. And when we tried to step out of the box for too long, we would catch a disease, and the box would be on a time frame that we would have to get back in the box, or we would die or never get back in the box at all. The box would then start to decrease in size, and the time frame you could stay out of the box got smaller, and more people began to die.
What?
There was no mention of COVID in the dream, but when I woke up, it was very obvious that perhaps I was in watching the news about COVID a bit too often. Love the podcast.
This is like the cube. The nightmare cube.
Yeah.
Just keeps shrinking and shrinking.
It was obviously like a reflection of how she felt. You know, like people were dying and the whole world was changing. Yeah. And, you know.
Very deep.
Very deep.
Very deep, that one.
They're also, like, dreams can be very metaphoric, can't they? Like, the way that they say that, you know, if you're, like, you dream that you're naked in front of an audience or whatever, it can be that you feel exposed or you're after exposing something in your real life, and now you just feel a bit too open or vulnerable.
Yeah,
or
you feel, yeah.
Your teeth are falling out, and you feel like you're out of control, and there's just nothing that you can do. There's no solid glue in your life to be able to control one thing or whatever. Yeah. Like, they're kind of metaphors, aren't they?
Yeah.
Do you know?
Yeah, there was two parts to that. What was the first one again?
That she was at the end of the bed looking at herself, and the man was beside her.
Astral projecting. Are you sure you weren't doing that?
Mmm. I don't think a kid would be able to.
I think a kid would be able to. I think they can open their minds enough to do it.
Yeah, but I think you need to astral project with, like, purpose, no? You need to know that you're trying to do that.
If anybody has tried astral projecting or feels like they can astral project, can you get on to
this? I've tried it. I just can't concentrate enough.
I've not tried it. It doesn't seem like something I'd like.
I think it'd be deadly.
I can't imagine, like, no.
A bit of background for the people in the back who don't have a clue what we're talking about
astral projection. Yeah. So apparently, if you get yourself to, like, it's a very Zen state, isn't it? You're supposed to lie down,
fucking enlightenment or something,
and like, you're supposed to, like, go past the point of
meditation,
mm-hmm. where you're something on meditation now in a moment, actually, to help you guys. So, where you, like, you go past a point. This is what I mean.
You lift out your own body.
My ADHD says no. So, like, it just, you basically come out of your own body and you can
go to a different dimension. Go to anywhere you want.
You go to a different dimension, but you can see yourself.
Yeah.
And I feel like a kid would be able to do, kids having a fucking clue what they're doing half the same. Maybe she was astral projecting, and maybe she wanted to do that because there was some kind of weird spirit.
Yeah.
And that was the man.
Yeah.
That was watching her watch her. Are you sure you weren't? I'd like to know more. Are you sure you weren't astral projecting?
I don't think she'd be able to tell you. She was a kid at the time.
But maybe now. Now she looks into it. Look into astral projecting, listener.
Let us know. It is mad. There's certain, like, look it up on TikTok, actually, because you can find certain playlists and everything on Spotify
to help you astral.
Essentially make you astral, but whatever the frequencies and the waves and stuff like that are, can trick your brain into, you know, like, just going into an absolute trance. And then there's obviously guided meditations to be able to do it and stuff. I just can't concentrate. And then I couldn't do it if I was there with Bobby, because what if I did? What if I left my body? And I was like, I want to go.
You were like, oh no.
To Florida. Yeah. I want to get on the Hulk.
See, that's what, how do you get back? I have so many questions.
No, you're very conscious during it. Like, you're able to do it. But apparently, like, you can lose control quite easily. And you can end up in very scary places.
Yeah, and you can end up...
You need to be concentrating, like...
Yeah, you need to be, like, you need to be happy that you're there, too. You need to be, like...
I need to be open-minded and not scared, because at the end of the day, it's invisible you. It's not physical you. You can't get hurt, like...
Then, like, nobody wake you. I have so many questions.
I know, yeah. I really will be shitting as well.
I want to know. Back. If you're an astral projector out there, let me know.
Also, the one that the girl that sent us the voice note, that is, I heard that before as well. You can't dream of somebody's face. You can't make it up.
Yeah, you have
in
to.
In your dreams, yeah.
But I think people forget how many faces you see a day.
And even on the telly, like.
Sometimes, have you ever had a dream where it's like, it's you, but it's not you, and it's your friend, but it's not your friend, and they look funny, or they're like an amalgamation of people?
It's your gaff, but it's not your gaff.
It's your gaff, but not your gaff.
Yeah.
It's your crab. It's your perfect crab, but it's not him either.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's Boy George with no face.
Exactly. I dream a lot. I'm going into another message. Maybe
let us know next time.
Another message. I dream a lot. It doesn't seem to be affected by food, etc. I've dreamt that my sister has told me she was dying with two days to live.
Oh.
In brackets, perfectly healthy. I've carried my best friend's coffin, boyfriend cheating, last night's dreams. I had my friend's baby for the day and I forgot the car seat. Realised when I got home, still holding her. Went to drive back, got somehow stuck in some sort of festival. You know, dreams that jump around and stuff. Then I had left the baby in the car on her own and I couldn't find my way back to the car. The sheer panic over the baby being so distressed, hungry, getting dehydrated, and I knew as time went on, the chances of the baby dying, and I was trying with all my being to get back and I couldn't. Thankfully woke up and had to get up and walk around the house to clear my head. Then dreamt that my friend's older kid, who was 6 years old, was driving the car with me, the baby and the brother, who was four, well able to drive, and me in the back in a panic, wouldn't stop or let me drive, and I've fucked up subconscious. Like, that's... Do you know, just something that she said there, do you ever, especially, and it's usually when you're sick or you can't sleep or you know you only have a certain amount of time to sleep and you're in that state where it's like, it's the same fucking dream and things just keep happening or you keep having the same thought or you're just stuck in this one situation but you know you're dreaming but there's nothing you're doing to control it.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, you keep waking up and you're like, no, do you know what? I actually have to get up and fucking walk around just to clear my head and get out of this.
Yeah.
I hate that. I hate it.
You're not a fan.
Not a fan. I don't think anybody would be a fan.
No. That's
sometimes it happens when I put Bobby to bed and then I start to drift off and then I start having a dream and I'm like, no, let's get up. And then I lie back down and go into the same dream again. And it's a fucking constant thing. Definition. And then I'm just like, right, Jen. Stop. I fucking hate getting stuck in stuff like that. I always dream that I'm late for work as well.
I hate that. I hate those little anxiety riddled ditties. Mm-hmm. Do you know? Those little diddly doos.
Annoying me. What I want to do when I have a dream is go places that I want to go to. Have a bit of crack.
That's what I mean. Like, why can't I be in Miami with like Drake? Do you know what I mean?
Maybe living your best life. Very rarely do you have good dreams.
Yeah.
Let alone, like, talking about bad dreams. Not often do you have good dreams.
No. No.
I want brilliant dreams.
There was one dream and I dreamt an investment I had made went really well.
Ah, deadly.
And I remember being like, I get to quit work now. I remember being like, oh my God, this is so good.
Mm.
The relief.
It's exactly how I wanted it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. It's exactly what I meant. Thank you, universe.
Although, do you know when you're having a bad dream and you wake up and you're like, thank fuck.
What I mean.
If you had a good dream and you woke up and you're like, ah, oh, shit.
See, that's the thing. And I remember waking up from it being like, oh, that didn't happen. Yeah. And that was shit.
You know? Yeah. What do you want? Like,
yeah. It's like, can I...
I don't know, I just want a dream that I'm getting an Indian head massage and just leave it at that.
Or like that they gave me an extra chicken nugget.
Yeah.
Do you know, like, something that is soul destroy me. Do you know what I mean? Something that's light. Light and airy is what I'm asking for, you know? Yeah. Something that isn't going to
That you're at a comedy show.
Yeah.
You get paid.
There's loads of jokes. Nice time, you know? Cracked. Yeah, it's been a great, yeah.
Or in your dream, you're on a night out.
Yeah,
but then you wake up, no hangover. You've had a great night.
Oh, you're pissed. But, oh, no, I'm not. Yeah.
Not dehydrated. No, this
I'm
great.
Actually fine. Yeah, yeah. Don't need the diuretic. No, that's what I mean. Like, why is there not more of that?
I know that there's ways that you can control, isn't it, lucid dreaming?
Yeah, where you manipulate your dream.
You need to get to a certain, it's like astral projection. You kind of need, they're kind of one in the same, but apparently astral projection is actually real. And you actually go to a different dimension and this is a thing in time. I don't know if I believe that. But lucid dreaming is very similar to it in that you get to a state where you're in so much control while you're asleep and in this dream that you're like, I'm in a dream. Let's go here.
Yeah.
And there have been times when I've been in a dream and I'm like, I'm dreaming.
Yeah.
I'm going to go here. But then my mind just always spins.
Spins and goes
And
off.
Then you end up, like that other girl said, like, you know, one of them jumpy dreams where you just end up from one place to the other.
Yeah.
Do you know? And then I don't know what I want. Do you know what I mean? Yeah. Like, if I was in a dream, like, right, I'm dreaming. I can do anything that I want. Can't fucking think of that.
Yeah.
What do I want? Do you know what I mean?
Yeah, I get that.
What do I want?
What do you want?
No fucking idea.
Yeah, what do you want to do? Like, what's the plan?
What's the crack?
Yeah.
Don't know what I want. I want a yacht. I'd love a yacht.
Yeah, true. Very true. Or you might dream you think you wanted something and then it turns out you didn't, you know? It's like if you got a new job and then you're like, oh no, I hated that.
Yeah.
You know?
I know, but it's not going to be exactly accurate in your head, is it?
True, Jen. It's very true. I've got a listener story here. When I was a kid, I had a nightmare about the McDonald's clown. Ronald.
Oh.
It's not the McDonald's clown, it's Sir Ronald.
Sir Ronald.
Sir Ronald McDonald. To you. He was at the top of the stairs up to the attic bedroom in my nanny and granddad's house and he was trying to kill me. I'll never forget it, but I was genuinely never able to go up into the attic bedroom ever again after it, even as an adult, and the house has only recently been sold, and up to the last time I was in the house, I couldn't look up the stairs. It was petrifying. He had a knife, and he had red eyes doing a crazy dance and running down the stairs towards me. I'll never forget it. I'm sure I've had far worse nightmares, but that's the one that will be with me until my last breath, betrayed by McDonald's.
It's mad how he's not really prevalent anymore, is Nina?
Ronald.
Yeah.
They wanted to get away from him, didn't they?
Yeah, he's very fucking similar to your man.
Anyways,
like.
Yeah. Tim Robinson.
Yeah, he's very similar to him. I don't get the fear of clowns. I get that loads of people do and they have an actual phobia of them. And they're terrified to the point where they freeze when they see them.
Yeah.
An awful lot of blokes that I know are afraid of clowns. But I can see why it's kind of terrifying. Yeah, Ronald hasn't really made. He used to be very prevalent in the Phibsborough.
Yeah, he was really big there, wasn't he?
Wasn't he?
He was a big lad there. Yeah, yeah.
I don't know why, because there was a mannequin of him upstairs in the Phibsborough one. I remember that. And there was a car.
Yeah.
Wasn't there?
Yeah.
Or was there a car-shaped table upstairs in Phibsborough in the McDonald's one?
Was there?
Why am I remembering that? There was a car. There was something shaped table up there. I don't even think it was the kids' party area. I think it was just
randomly
fucking
there.
Deadly McDonald's. Like, but Ronald Wood, there was a big mannequin of him there.
See, there was one. Grafton Street was very Ronald, but they moved with the times quick and they made it very sleek.
Grafton Street when I was more of an O'Connell Street McDonald's kind of when had an upstairs. I was like,
oh no, never. Oh god,
the O'Connell Street one.
No.
Oh sorry.
Fuck off.
Sorry, you went to Grafton Street.
You went to O'Connell Street.
I went to O'Connell
Street. We're so different.
Yeah. Sorry about that. Just went there when we came out. You obviously went there when you came out of Stephen's Green.
Bram Thomas. Oh, God. I have another one here. I think this is interesting because it's touching on a few things. Always for me, I frequently wake up bawling my eyes out and I have recurring nightmares. 100% me not dealing with what's going on in my life and pretending that it's not happening.
Yeah.
A lot of the time it's parents or close friends dying or I've dreamt of being stabbed by a college friend so vividly while everybody watched. Yes, I have issues. Also, once on a group trip, there was around 7 or 8 of us in a 2-bedroom apartment in Barcelona and one of the girls woke up screaming like blood-curdling scream, and she was still sleeping. I thought we were all about to be murdered. She, quote-unquote, saw someone in the corner.
God.
Oh, God.
Jesus.
That was me with the Japanese baby. But and Tom doesn't believe any shit, but he believes the Japanese baby.
Does he?
Yeah. Because he was like, you were not okay. That story really has affected a lot of people.
Yeah. I don't doubt it.
You know, it's mad. Yeah, the whole you not dealing with stuff that's going on in your life. Recently, I've been dreaming about situations that I'm not happy with.
Yeah.
Do you get me?
Mm-hmm.
Which I find very strange.
I mean, dreams are obviously psychological because it's what your brain does without your control.
Yeah.
And it's obviously where your subconscious lies.
But I'm like, we know this. Do you know what I mean? I'm like, we know this because we think about this.
We obviously haven't dealt
in real life. We don't like this. So why am I here?
You've no closure.
Yeah.
You haven't dealt with it.
Yeah.
That's where your subconscious lies. And that's the part of the brain that you can't, well, you can control, but over time, you need to train it.
Wow. Well.
Mm-hmm. It's about unlearning behaviours and teaching it stuff.
Generous.
Controlling the paradigm. Not sure, this is another listener. Just in case you think that. Yeah. I'm just
going straight into it. Back. Living my life.
I'm just discovering these things. Not sure if you consider this a nightmare, but I woke up pretty traumatised. I had a dream the other night that my whole family ordered a big, huge Chinese order from a faraway Chinese. So when it arrived, my order wasn't in the box. So I just had to sit there while everybody else was eating. But seriously, I used to have nightmares. That is a nightmare.
That would really upset me.
I'd be fucking raging.
I'd wake up and I'd be like, for fuck's sake, Shangri-La again. Fucking hell.
Food envy is one thing when you have food. Yeah. But when you don't have food.
When you don't have food, you knew it.
Get the knife out. But seriously, I used to have nightmares of some man chasing me all the time. It was like I was trying to run, but I couldn't. Would always wake up before he caught me down. And I used to always have nightmares of my teeth falling out. And it would always feel so real. I would wake up and have to check that my teeth were still there.
That was your big mammy voice. Yeah, teeth falling out.
No, well, that was me going to sleep. We've talked about that now. We said that. Yeah, you sound like you didn't really have much control over your life when you were younger. That's my psychological analysis.
As Manelli lies. Yeah, teeth falling out, again, not something I've experienced. All that other kind of stuff. That would upset, the food one would upset me, I'm sorry. It would really annoy me. It would upset me.
Yeah, in the grand scheme of things and what's going on in the world, a mild inconvenience.
Oh, this is really interesting.
Okay, go on.
So, we have a listener story here.
Yeah.
I've horrific nightmares, generally around fire or ghosts or being chased. The weird thing is, I always dream in black and white.
Ah.
Didn't actually realise this until I got pregnant, and all of a sudden my dreams became technicolor bright and super, super vivid, like would wake up thinking the dream was real. The minute I gave birth, back to black and white, and now pregnant again. Hello, crazy bright dreams.
Oh my God.
My husband though, Jesus, he gets sleep paralysis, but for years called it stuck in his sleep.
Oh.
Oh God, literally would be screaming in his sleep, unable to wake up, even with me punching him very hard. It happens to his whole family. When our daughter was born, this became dreaming that she was in his arms and he would sit up cradling a pillow and shushing it.
Oh no.
That's cute, no?
It's cute, but fucking hell.
Yeah.
Serious stuff going on there, like. Yeah.
She goes, honestly, between the two of us, nighttime is wild.
Yeah, I was going to say.
Throw a baby in there, I'd say it's a wild, wild old time.
Pregnancy dreams are mad, I will say. They get hell of a lot more crazy.
I've heard that.
Yeah.
Loads. It's like quite a well-known thing, isn't it? Where it's like when you're pregnant, it's like almost like you're fucking dreaming for two.
That's it. No, they're just more vivid.
Yeah.
They're more lifelike.
Yeah, because it's your memory plus baby's memory pushing it through.
I don't think it's baby's memory.
It is. It's the two you are both fused together. I've decided.
The heightened hormones and fucking heightened body temperature and stuff like that. But it is. They're a lot more vivid. And the sleep is an awful lot more fucking hard to do when you're pregnant.
Yeah.
Horrible.
That's what I mean, though, as well. I'm like, I feel so sorry for pregnant women who can't sleep, you know, the last trimester, and they're like, horrible. Fuck this now.
Yeah.
Because I'm like, how are you supposed to be a functioning human? Like, how are you supposed to?
It's just training for when the baby comes along, I suppose. But it's like, this is my last chance to get a full night's sleep.
Yeah.
Not getting woken up by a little fucking baby. And here we are, can't even sleep. Just can't. You're just not in the humour of sleeping.
Really?
Yeah, just not in the, and you're bored. You don't want to watch a series. You don't want to like do anything else. You know that you should be sleeping, but you just can't. It's just a shit time. Shit.
Isn't it funny when you wake up and you're like, no, I'm not in the mood to do absolutely anything other than try and sleep right now.
Yeah, but
you're like, don't want to read a book, don't want to do any of that shit. Just very fuming at the moment, just very annoyed.
Yeah.
But, so there's this guy on TikTok, I can't remember his name, apologies, but I saw his little video, I don't follow him or anything, but a video came up and it was like, ways to help like reduce anxiety and stress.
Mm-hmm.
And he was like, this is also really good if you have trouble getting back to sleep.
Oh yeah.
So, if you tilt your head back.
Right.
And look up. So tilt your head back and then you look up like that.
Uh-huh.
And close your eyes. We'll kind of have it changes your brainwave.
Oh.
And your brain can't, like, it can't, like,
fight against it. Like,
it can't. Yeah, basically your brainwaves change and it instantly relaxes you.
You're making it do it, like.
And it does work.
Does it?
Yeah. I've been trying it and I said it to Tom one of the days as well. And he's like, oh, holy shit, that works. Yeah. So if you literally tilt your head back gently. And then look up and then close your eyes.
Yeah. Well, I suppose...
Like you get an instant calmness. Ah. Yeah. And there was somebody else I saw, probably a video, probably TikTok, let's not lie.
It spend is. Spend 90% of my life on the thing.
Yeah. Yeah. I'm like, I'm just going to log on 6 hours later. I'm like, oh,
stop.
I didn't need to sleep. Apparently as well, if you're having a panic attack or if you're like in a very anxious state,
yeah,
pick a spot and stare at it. And don't break away because your eyes need to move for you to have like intrusive and intense thoughts. So apparently if you pick a spot and you still your eyes,
okay,
you'll immediately again calm down.
Right. Because
your eyes need to flicker and move and need to kind of, for your brain to be ticking away.
Right.
Yeah, for your brain to be having that panic attack or that anxious episode and all that other kind of crack. Yeah, those are two little things.
Fuck.
Yeah.
I saw one just while they're talking about that. There was one, you know, the Sweetmans, they're always on this morning. That couple, they look a bit like Barbie and Ken. They're all about.
Really?
Yeah. If I showed you a picture of them, you'd know.
Okay.
I'll show you a picture later. But if you know, you intertwine your hands like that,
mm-hmm,
like do a praying sign and then interlock your fingers, like the way that you naturally, comfortably do it, and then change,
yeah,
the position, change, and you're like,
move the fingers from one, move the fingers the
down one pace, yeah, to the way that you wouldn't naturally do it.
Oh, I hate it.
And it feels weird.
Oh, I hate
but
it.
Then you're supposed to leave your hands in that position and completely relax. So drop your shoulders, take a deep breath, sink into the chair, take a deep breath. Now it takes about like 7 different relaxing different parts of your body, and then you put your fingers back to the comfortable position, back into the uncomfortable position, and there's no difference.
No way.
Yeah, it changes your brain, but do it while you're having a panic attack because it completely knocks your brain. Yeah, yeah, reconfigures everything.
It's something to do with. I just thought it was so interesting. It resets it. It does make sense with the brain waves, doesn't it?
Yeah.
Really interesting, gang. Really interesting over here.
Meds.
I don't know if you call it a nightmare, but years ago I dreamt that I was on the Titanic and I died. I came back as a ghost to look at my life, and in the dream I was standing out in the back garden of my family home thinking that I couldn't believe that I was dead and I had left my family. And to the side of me was like a see-through ghost of the Titanic in the garden.
So deep.
Do you know what that reminds me of? You know that Google thing that they have now where you can see the zebra and you're like, what the fuck? You know? What? So if you Google zebra,
okay,
there's like a thing and it's like a virtual reality and it'll be like you can put the zebra in your room.
Fuck off.
Yeah, it's really weird. On your phone.
Oh, okay. I'll do it in a while.
So you can like point it like where you want and you're like, fuck. Yeah.
Right.
That just reminds me, well, there's the Titanic way. I woke up bawling, crying, and my mom and dad were both at work, so the only other person in the house was my older brother. So I was traumatized, as you can imagine, and retold him the dream. He burst out laughing, called me thick, but then told me that if it was supposed to be good luck if you dream that you die.
Mm.
I think he felt guilty for laughing at me because I was so upset. Anyway, wow. I was 17 then and I'm 28 now and I'll never forget it. Titanic.
They do say stuff like that, don't they? Like if somebody that you know in your dream dies, it's supposed to mean they're going to have a really long life. I don't know how that fucking works.
How do they figure that shite out?
I don't know. I think it's a superstitious kind of thing. I just like, calm the fuck down.
Calm down, love. You're absolutely did you know, crazy. You're crazy today.
Did you know if your dad dies in your dream, it's going to live till
he's
100?
It's
going to
live a very long life. It's going to live to 100.
Oh,
shit. Oh, nearly knocked the microphone over.
He's going to live till he's 100.
All right.
Derek Cora said that. Here's another one. Recurring nightmare. Every few months, every few months that I can't find my Leaving Cert maths classes and I fail maths in the Leaving. Haunts me to this day, 11 years later. I passed an honours maths back in the day. Must have serious trauma in there from the stress of it.
I love the way you put in the honours. I passed honours. Maths.
Red honour.
Just to let you guys know, it's honours. Be honest, I don't know many people who did do honours maths. So congrats to that. Yeah,
well done. Absolutely.
Honours maths. I feel like it's probably an unpopular opinion. Oh. But I find dreams that are just riddled with anxiety and stressful inducing situations so much more troubling. Like, I'd never wake up shook from a scary dream, but I'd be in bits from an anxiety dream. One where every 5 seconds something goes wrong.
Yeah. Because it's more, like, a scary dream, you're less likely to see a monster in real life. Whereas you're more likely to be late for work.
Yeah, that's, it's like, okay, we know the green cheese isn't going to happen, Carla. It's not happening. Japanese baby, however,
You never know.
A real thing that happened to me.
Will. Yeah, like the dreams that could actually come true that you're not into.
Yeah.
Don't like that for us.
Don't like that for me.
This is a weird and a bit of a long one, so apologies. I've had a recurring nightmare for 25 years and I've no idea what it means. I'm standing, looking up at the stage, and I'm surrounded by rubbish and all these little gnome things jumping in and out of the rubbish. I look back up at the stage and it's spotless and glaringly white. This woman walks from the back of the stage, strikingly beautiful blonde, very pale, in a long white dress and a cape. She holds her hand up, looks at me, starts counting down from 5.
Oh, bitch, no. Imagine that. Imagine this weird fucking person coming at you.
Counting down from five.
I'd be like, don't get to 1, girl. Don't do it.
Once she gets to 1, that's part of the story, everything goes black and I wake up. Invariably, I wake up and have been crying in my sleep. I have no idea what it's meant to mean, but I'm still having it to this day and I have it a few times a year.
Oh. No.
That's strange.
I'd rather not
so
dream
specific
at all than that. That's very strange.
Isn't it? Like the gnomes jumping in and out of the bin. All of a sudden the stage is pristine. And then you're 1. Counting
5,
down. 4.
Yeah, I'd be like,
oh, I don't know. Would
not you,
you like
not you motherfucker, not you.
I would try and find out some sort of dream interpreter.
Yeah. Online. So I'd be like, not this woman again.
Usually they take submissions, don't they?
They do. Yeah, they do. Actually, they do. That. Yeah, find maybe an Instagram one. Yeah. Find maybe an Instagram one with a question box, you know?
Yeah.
Great stuff.
I would go about finding out what that's about.
Yeah.
Because you probably have unresolved childhood trauma.
Jen is diagnosed.
Usually. Yeah, that's my opinion.
That's your opinion. I suffered from night terrors as a child. Almost every night I would have them. Couldn't see my family even though I was standing right in front of them. There were 3 reoccurring ones, but could never explain what was happening as they were more just feelings that happened, which caused me the terror.
Mm.
Heard one of sounds from 1 last year and didn't trigger anything, but brought back all of the memories. I'm 12 weeks pregnant and this last week has been Nightmare Central. Dreamt I was looking after a friend's child and the bath was running by the time, By the time I went in, he was face down, bed an inch of water. Oh my God.
Oh my God.
He was okay in the dream, but couldn't get back to sleep and it shook me so bad. Another one where I was talking to my mum in the kitchen of my house. Blinds started going up and down and a book flew off the counter in front of me. Again, it shook me so much I couldn't sleep. Both were so real. Only way I knew that they weren't is because my house is spotless in both. Thanks for the podcast. Been keeping me going on my morning walks. Otherwise, I'd be stuck in the house 24/7 with exhaustion and nausea.
Oh, God.
I'm delighted that you enjoy them now, girly. But those sound shite.
Best of luck with the rest of the pregnancy, I hope. The dreams aren't as... bad for the rest
that
of
can't
it.
Be my gaff, it's way too clean.
Yeah. Lavender, try a bit of lavender. The last one that I have here. I used to have a recurring nightmare as a child that I was being attacked by a cat. It used to scare the shit out of me and it stopped for years, and recently enough I had one again. I had never really looked too much into it, but when I what, when I last had the nightmare, I Googled it. So this, for the other girl that was saying that, maybe Google it. And it said that it means that you are feeling threatened by someone in your waking life, which at the particular time I was feeling that way. Don't know who I was feeling threatened by as a child. Probably the childhood bully that you have since blocked out.
Jen's also diagnosing you with trauma.
Everybody has it, Carla. Shall we go to our unpopular opinion of the week?
Yeah.
You triggered my unpopular opinion this week.
I'm your unpopular opinion?
No, you triggered it.
Okay.
With your stories when you were packing for Valencia.
Valencia, yeah.
And you had, or maybe, no, you bought in Sephora in Valencia.
Yeah.
Highlighters. Now, obviously, Mewers are going to disagree with me, or you can, this is my ignorance
where
speaking.
Where are you going with this?
So, let's delve into me. Now, don't interrupt me. Listen to my opinion, and then we can discuss, right?
I don't like it.
Little pots of highlighter.
Yeah.
I don't believe there should be that fucking many of them available on the market. They're pots of highlighter. They remind me of the Tin Man being melted down and put into a little bottle. And I just don't see the point when you use so little on the face. Discuss.
So you think they should be smaller?
I don't see the big fucking deal in them in the first place. When you can easily get a pressed one and use the same amount. Because literally there's a tiny few bits of the face that they even belong on.
Yeah.
There's no need for so much of it. Or so, like so many variations of it.
So you're just mad at highlighter in general?
I just don't fucking... Ugh.
You don't use highlighter though?
I don't really.
Yeah.
I see a difference when I do use it. But at the same time, like say in press drops and so, and I don't get many makeup press drops, but when I do get a makeup press drop, there's always at least 3 highlighters in it. And I'm like, why? Why? Who uses that? Have you ever gotten to the bottom of a pan of highlighter?
Yeah.
Have you?
Yeah.
You're gas.
I know.
You're genuinely.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't get it.
Yeah.
Why are the pots so big? Why do you so, what, how many do you have on, I know you don't know the actual amount because you've far too many.
Yeah, I do.
How many do you have?
Like over 100.
Why? This is what I mean. It's a waste. No?
It's, no, I think as well, you have to remember that things are getting upgraded. Formulas are getting changed all the time. Do you know?
Are they that different though?
Yeah, because there, you have to remember when we, the problem is with makeup and the problem is with any kind of real trend is that it gets into the hands of the of people.
Like me, who don't know what they're talking about.
I don't know what they're talking about. I don't know what they're doing. So there, everyone's like, look like a tin man, blah, blah, blah. Yeah, you know, it's the same fucking shit narrative that you're hearing from people constantly. And you're just like, oh, shut up. But I suppose highlighters kind of, you know, when I was younger, I loved a real sparkly highlighter. Like I wanted it to look like I was wearing highlight. You know?
Yeah.
Whether it's now, because I've grown up and because, you know, trends have changed and I'm, you know, products are better. I like it to look like sweaty on the skin. Do you know what I mean? Like a sweat.
Dewy.
Like a dewy goddess. So that's probably why. And also you looking for different tones. So like, for instance, when I have tan on, I have to use a different highlighter than I do.
I get that there's gold and champagne and like a hint of glow or whatever the fuck.
Yeah.
Like they're, what are we talking, white champagne and gold based?
Well, you also could have like, yeah, there's loads of different, like you can have like a copper one for deeper skin tones. Yeah. You have like a rose base. Like I have a highlighter that's pure purple, which is actually kind of cool because it just comes with like a lilac fleck. Looks pretty cool.
Right.
On the skin.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, but that's what I mean. There's just like over the years, I don't know, I just really like buying makeup.
Yeah, yeah.
I just enjoy it.
Yeah.
I'd like, there's probably no new formula out there that's gonna.
Yeah.
Like if I had to reshop my makeup, like if I went into my.
Yeah, yeah.
And highlighter drawer, yeah. I would almost reshop. You get me?
Would you? Like,
reshop for my own kind of stash.
Right, okay.
Yeah. So, yeah, no, I. Yeah, sometimes they can be very big.
Yeah. No, I'm just, I suppose, well, again, me coming from a place of ignorance, don't really use it, don't really know how to place it properly. Have used it, have noticed the difference, but not that into it. When I see somebody like, say yourself, mm-hmm. coming up after doing a makeup haul,
yeah,
and like it's slide after slide of all different highlighters, I'm just like, nope, That's my opinion. That's my unpopular opinion.
Here, swipe on.
Just, I'm just like, I couldn't be arsed with this.
But I also do want to say that makeup is supposed to be like, when a person buys a highlighter, it's not for someone like me who's going to go and buy 100 more.
Yeah.
Do you get
me?
So it's like their one highlight that they use every, it's like their one foundation, their one concealer, and they use it until it's done. Same with the highlight. It's like,
yeah,
it's about, it's like you use your one highlighter every day and then it's done. So you get the most value out of it because it's big.
Okay. I'm still not that into it.
No, I don't think you are.
Have you got a No, in fairness, for someone like you though, like a makeup artist who's into the artistry of it, hence your Insta name, artistry, I get it. I get why you would be into it, and it's, it makes absolute sense for you. For a normal plain Jane like myself, just
I do get. Look, yeah. I understand. You don't have to like it just because I like it. Okay.
Yeah, that's all right. Absolutely. Have you got a stamper of the week?
I absolutely.
And
do.
Are you ready to go? Because I still haven't lengthened.
I'm ready to go, girly pops. You still haven't done that for me.
Kyla's stamper of the week.
So last week's stamper of the week was Chloe and Halle.
Yeah.
So Chloe, out of Chloe and Halle, has just released her new single called Have Mercy, and it's a fucking bop.
Right.
And you guys have probably heard it on TikTok.
Okay.
You probably have heard the...
You're hooked up to the dick.
Yeah, but I can't hear anything.
Play a little bit. Oh, sorry. Let me heighten it.
Lord. I keep pausing like I do. I keep pausing like I do. I keep pausing like I do.
Okay.
I keep pausing like I do.
I haven't heard that on TikTok.
Really?
No.
It's so good anyway.
There's a lot of bass in it.
There's a lot of bass in it. But she has just launched her solo project.
Right.
So her sister, who's Halle, she is the Little Mermaid. Yeah, and drummer was all the scandal and
yeah.
So they're both at the VMAs, but like it's she's now obviously done her like little solo project, but she's shit hot. Love her,
right?
Love the tune, bit of a bop, good for like a gym and like work down. Do you know, in that kind of way?
It sounds like a real twerking song.
It's a real kind of like
yeah. It's good. Cool. That's all for now. We're gonna go and record our Patreon episode. We're going to be talking about the Met Gala.
You guys asked us to.
Apparently there's a lot to be discussed. I will be learning this episode because
Jen will be nodding.
I don't have much pop culture. I'm not that. I actually look like an owl on my kids, don't I? I can't wait until we have visuals on this. I don't really have much knowledge of it, for sure. Look, I let you as kids talk about it and I'll listen in, you know?
Go on.
Go on. I'll talk to you then.
Go on.